So this is the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 2 and it's finally got One UI 4.0. I've had it just over a week now on this phone and I know there's a ton of videos about One UI 4.0 on the Z Fold 3, but I didn't see too much on the Z Fold 2, so I want to take a look, see what's changed, and let you guys know how it is so far. So in terms of overall changes, it's going to be very similar to what the changes were like for the Galaxy S21 with One UI 4.0. The biggest thing that I've noticed with the S21 and this phone is the performance difference. I think there was a far more noticeable improvement in performance on the Galaxy S21. So the performance jump wasn't as big, but it was definitely still noticeable. The animations are overall smoother. The opening of apps is much faster. Generally, it's very nice to see any kind of performance improvement with an update. Usually, you typically see the same or even slower experience, but One UI 4.0 on the Z Fold 2 has been very good in terms of performance. The one spot where One UI 4.0 did not do too well is in terms of battery. Now, it didn't get that much worse. It actually didn't get that much better. It's just about the same. So even though One UI 4.0 and Android 12 is supposed to make some battery efficiency improvements with how Android handles background apps, but yeah, I haven't seen too much of an improvement in terms of battery performance on this phone. In terms of feature parity with the Z Fold 3, it's actually been about the same except for the S Pen features since a couple updates ago. Yeah, there has been feature parity between the Z Fold 2 and the Z Fold 3 for quite some time now. So it's got all the features you need that's on the Z Fold 3, like you can pin this side panel multitasking bar onto the side of your phone, and you got all the same features with the Z Fold 3, so there's not too much difference between the two phones anymore. So besides performance, the biggest thing you're going to notice about One UI 4.0 on the Z Fold 2 is that the home screen, the general UI is different. So what's really new with Android 12 is that you can really customize your UX UI with your own set of colors that adapt to what you're doing on the phone and what you have as your background wallpaper. So I currently have this blue color because it has adapted to my more teal blue background here. But as you can see, you can change the color of your accents and it will all adapt to your menus, your backgrounds, and some app icons as well. Another big change with One UI 4.0 is dark mode. Dark mode has seen some improvements. So as you can see, within light mode, everything is much brighter, including the background wallpaper. But once you turn on dark mode, it's not just the UI that changes colors, it also darkens the app icons and the background as well. And a really big thing that you'll notice with One UI 4.0 is that there are brand new widgets. The widgets are very uniform. Of course, this doesn't apply to all widgets, but it does apply to third-party widgets as well. It gets more rounded corners. As you can see, it really applies to the first-party Samsung widgets. They're very uniform. You can keep your home screen very consistent, which I really like. And you don't have to stay to these dark, boring colors. You can also change the color of these icons to match to your dark mode or your light mode, or change it to white, change the opacity. It's very customizable. I have to admit, it looks a little weirder on the front screen because it's so small, but yeah, it's still very consistent with the front and the main screen, which I really like. If you hold onto the home screen and go to your widget selection menu, it's been much more streamlined. Everything's easier to find in this list view, and it also gives you recommendations on what else you should put on your home screen. Another nice addition is the widgets in the lock screen. If you tap on the clock here, you get a list of widgets. I believe this feature has been there, but I don't know, it's in the changelog, so I'll go over it. But yeah, you have widgets once you click the clock in your lock screen, and you can do very quick tasks, what you need to do, check your weather real quick, see where your alarm's at, and also control your media as well. So another new cool thing about the lock screen is that if you have Bluetooth headphones connected, like the Pixel Buds here, you can just change the output to back to your phone if you're trying to show your friend a music that you liked. So if you just click on media output, you can just switch it to this phone, and then control the volume there. So as you all know, there's the always on display. You can see your notifications real quick, as well as the time and how much battery you have. So the always on display does have a new feature. I have it to tap to show, so I don't really want to see it unless I tap to check the time or something like that. But this new option lets you only have it turn on for new notifications, which is pretty nifty. So those are some of the home screen features, but I wanted to show some multitasking features that are new with Android 12, but also some special features that are exclusive for One UI 4. So one Android 12 feature that's new is, let's say you have a YouTube video playing, and you have picture-in-picture, right? Now you don't have to necessarily search for a corner to resize it. It's been hard to control that way. Now you can pinch the zoom and make it really as big as you want. And this is really fantastic once you have the phone open to the main screen. You can make it as big as almost half the screen. So you can really do anything. You can check your social media while your video is playing and really resize it. I really like this new picture-in-picture feature. So another new multitasking feature that makes this tablet UI more desktop-y is that you can pin the pop-up menu mini bar onto the top of the app. So you can just have it as a menu, much like you see on Windows. You can use this pinned menu to make the app full screen. You can also minimize it to an icon, tap it back. You can also unpin your menu bar just by clicking here and back to your simple menu. One more thing about multitasking, I did mention this on my One UI 4 video for the Galaxy S21, but it's seen the same changes on the Z Fold 2. Samsung Dex now allows you to resize more apps, so it's more of a complete desktop experience and more apps are now compatible to play with as Windows. Besides the home screen and some multitasking features, there are a lot of little changes within the first party apps in Samsung's One UI. The camera app has seen a lot of changes, so once you zoom in, it gives you the numbers for how much you're zoomed in by, so it's easier to control and not have to guesstimate where you're at. The pro photography mode has seen a lot of changes as well. It's a little more easier to use. I don't particularly use this feature much, but this is great for photography nerds. But a change that I do care about is the scanning feature on the camera app. So it sees a document here, it says tap to scan. It automatically goes to this editing menu. You can adjust what your document should look like when it's scanned, save, and you have your straightened document right there. So another new thing about scanning is that once it scans a QR code, if I can get it, it gives you the option to get more options and open it in your browser, copy it, or if it's a phone number, it lets you call it directly from this app. So one of the biggest things going on in tech right now is privacy and how apps and services are using your information on your tech devices. So Android 12 has a lot of new privacy features and One UI adds on top of that. So one thing I really appreciate is when you have an app open and it's using one of your cameras, your microphones, or anything like that, the app, the UI lets you know. The UI, as you can see, it shows you in the green bubble in the corner that it's using your camera. So if an app is sneakily using your camera or microphone, the One UI will let you know. So I may not use Samsung's stock gallery app too much, but there are a lot of people that do. And there was a time where I did used to use it, and there are a lot of changes to the gallery app on One UI 4.0. So as you can see for this photo, you can change the details of where the photo was taken and also when it was taken if you click the edit button. This is important when your friend sends you a picture of a group photo they took together, and the app that you download the photo from doesn't seem to show the right location or the date. So you can just change it so that your memories are in the right kind of timeline and get your photo gallery more organized. So the gallery app has a ton of new editing features for your photos, and one of which is the light adjusting control. If you can see, you can just easily adjust your lighting, make it brighter, darker, without having to go through each of the settings here. And let's say you made a ton of changes to your photo and you made it super stylistic and contrasty and you saved it, and then you regret it. So you can also go back to the editing tool and revert back to your original, because it saved what the photo was actually at, so you don't have to worry about losing the original photo. So let's say you want to share the photo and you click the share button right there. Android 12 and One UI has a brand new share menu, and you can see the list of apps here, which you can customize by clicking more here and then clicking this pencil icon, and then you can control the order of which the apps are ordered in your share menu, so you can really customize what apps show up first when you want to share something. So in contrast to popular belief, I actually like the Samsung keyboard. It's my preferred default keyboard. I think it's very responsive and accurate, and I love the top toolbar. It's very, very useful. So I just wanted to say that. Anyways, the new thing about this keyboard is that the emoji button is much easier to access, and there are a ton of new options. I don't use the GIF, so I guess I didn't agree to that. But yeah, it's very easy to access your stickers and your GIFs and your emoji in the search bar is much easier to access from here. So another first party app that's seen a lot of UI changes is the Samsung Health app. I know not everyone has a Samsung smartwatch or smart band, but I personally do use this app just to track my steps. I honestly don't know too many difference with this app because I don't actually go into it other than counting my steps, but yeah, it apparently does have an easier UI, and I do see that it seems much more consistent with One UI's rounded corners and all that. One thing I like to mention is that the app is now a little more inclusive for profiles, so you can click some of the new gender options that are available here. While I don't use Samsung Health to record my food or track my calories, I know that there are a lot of people that do, and it does have a lot of new food options for you to do that. And the last thing I want to go over is the new settings menu. There are some options in the settings that has seen some changes. So if you go into battery and device care, you can see how your phone is doing overall. It tracks how your battery life is doing, how much storage you have, and also what your RAM usage is like at the moment. And if you do have any issue with your phone regarding security or some apps draining your battery too much, it will show up here saying the status is not good. But here, it seems pretty good. You can click optimize now. It might clear some apps that were taking way too much of your RAM or anything like that. And then your phone's gonna be great now, apparently. So one more new thing in the device care options is now that there's a diagnostics button. So this doesn't really open within the settings, it opens the Samsung Members app, but it gives you an easy access to really test out all the functions of your phone to make sure there's nothing wrong. Last but not least, let's talk about Bixby Routines. I know nobody uses Bixby, but I know that there are people that use the Bixby Routines feature because it is actually pretty useful. So what One UI has changed about that is that it gives you more options to do more with these custom Bixby routines. So like I mentioned, you can add various if and then statements to really customize what your phone does at a certain event. So when a game is being played, I can have enhanced processing on so that the game plays faster and I can have a smoother experience. There's a lot more new options that people can add as if and then statements to make your experience on One UI much more customizable. So yeah, that's pretty much One UI in a nutshell. That's a lot of new little changes that a lot of people may not notice because there aren't that many big UI changes, but I do appreciate all the changes that Samsung's made here, and I do love the update in terms of giving me a performance boost for my older devices. Alright guys, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you guys thought of One UI 4.0 and especially what you think of it on the Z Fold 2. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.